to Dads is a podcast to help men understand and navigate the transition of being a single dude into a family man. How do we make sense of it all? Well, we probably won't be able to, but let's go ahead and have some fun trying. And we are back.
We're back.
I'm Jason Kreidman.
And I'm Alan Bush.
And this is Dudes to Dads. Alan, how are you this week?
I am okay.
Your head up?
My head is up. I'm so burnt out. It's a long week, but already it's only...
Well, long day, too.
Long day, yeah. So, but it's good. Very good. Still positive energy. I got it.
Sit up straight?
Yep. Got to do my jumping jacks. Did you have your coffee?
Oh, you forgot your coffee.
No, I got water. That's good enough.
So the topic for today is about noise.
Noise.
And how noise is distracting for children.
Okay. That makes sense.
So a question for you first.
Yeah.
When you study, or think back when you were in school, or if you're doing work, do you listen to music while you work?
Sometimes I do. I've learned to listen to music or sometimes podcasts while I'm working. I don't get distracted as easily by background noise, but it depends on the type of work. If I really need to get something done, I will take the time. And
so it's more monotonous tasks.
Yeah.
If you're doing monotonous like a spreadsheet, tasks,
exactly.
Copy and paste.
Yeah. Basically. Yeah. Okay. As there's things I have to like evaluate and really analyze, I probably don't like to be distracted.
Well, the thing to consider would be, does that music have words?
Oh yeah. That's a good point.
You said the podcast. The podcast
has plenty of words, but you're right. There are some times I'd rather hear instrumentals,
right,
and things that don't have a lot of words to them because it's
distracting.
It is distracting. Yeah.
So think about noise when you're not only, I mean, if you're concentrating and working, that's one thing, but think about noise in an environment. Hmm. You know, if you are having a conversation in a bar, or someplace, restaurant, something, and it's really loud, it's hard to focus.
Yeah.
You know, it's hard to focus often, you know, forget about somebody yelling, but you're hearing other things. You're hearing all sorts of things, you know, from different people.
Yeah.
And you're trying to concentrate on what somebody is saying. It can be difficult.
Yeah.
So this is the case where children are much more distracted in their brain. Their brain is much more distracted than an adult.
Yeah.
So multiple times over. So I was reading an article about this, and basically it shows that research is now showing, or it's been showing, but that was another study
came out. Yeah.
That how noise, and especially this background noise with words, can really hinder how a child learns.
Makes sense. Yeah.
I mean, yeah, it does make sense. Because, you know, children will hear different things than adults do. You know, they just hear differently.
Yeah. And I think adults tune things out pretty easily. I think maybe especially if you're used to being the
spouses
type to focus
do.
On. Yeah, exactly. Well, you're talking about the bar scenario, and this, I'll let you go back to what you're saying, but that struck a chord with me because I'm thinking about it in a bar or something that's noisier. Mm-hmm. In a weird way, you just habituate to the noise because it's like all you're hearing is it's bubbling in a weird way. You don't, but if it's like individual conversations that are right next to you, you'd get more distracted. If it would be like, if you heard everything that was going on in this person,
my wife will, it's funny. She'll point out sometimes where, you know, she can even be talking a few people over and I hear my name.
Right.
While I'm in another conversation, or I actually can, I've listened to conversations while I converse with somebody.
Exactly. Especially if you hear your name.
Yeah. And I hear my name or something. So, what's over there? Like across the room. She's like, what, how did you know that I was talking? You know, I just have like a sixth sense. I have really good hearing. You know?
An old colleague used to say that he'd get on conference calls and then he'd like press mute and just do other stuff. And then he'd know when they were going to talk to him and he'd go, no, yeah, that sounds good. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, no, totally. And he'd press mute again and just jump back in.
That's awesome. Clients, not do that.
Yeah, right, yeah, exactly.
Totally paying attention.
I'm totally paying attention to everything that's going on.
Right. yeah, and so and part of it is they're less equipped to deal with the speech that, you know, you're trying to understand.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, just physically not able to deal with it.
Yeah.
We,
yeah.
One of the examples was like a brief noise, like a cough or, you know, say you're having a conversation and all of a sudden there's like a loud noise, like a horn, a cough, something. As adults, we can kind of process what may have been said.
Right.
Like we can make that leap.
Yeah. It's almost like a reflex to us.
Yeah. Well, you just over time you learn and maybe it's reading lips, whatever. I mean, you've kind of you can hear what still is going on. A child gets totally disrupted.
Yeah.
And the pattern and they're like, whoa, like their brain doesn't fill in the gap, if you will,
right,
of what that conversation could be. So, yeah, it can be a little difficult, you know, for kids to do that. So imagine like in a you know, a classroom setting.
Yeah,
you know, you've got all these kids talking, blah, blah, blah. You know, that's why, I mean, that's why teachers don't like kids talking.
Yeah, because it's distracting to the teacher sometimes, but mostly to the people trying to learn.
Right. And that's, you know, it's funny because we always think that that's what they're saying.
Yeah.
It's not true, but it's really true.
Totally true.
It's like,
yeah,
you know, when the kids are talking, it doesn't allow for you to really hear what's going on.
Right.
You know, and so, you know, for their ability to process speech against the noise, it's just, they say that it doesn't really mature until adolescence.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, I mean, it takes years.
I guess so. And it is, you think about it, they are kind of new at the language, you know, they're learning because they didn't get to learn to speak until they're probably like in their, you know, what, 2 or 3.
Yeah.
And
then
they get used to understanding the nuances, the speech, and then the language itself they're getting adapted to. So they have to process all this information.
Well, I was thinking about, you know, a lot of people, which we'll talk about some of the tips that, you know, to sort of reduce the noise, if you will, but also, you know, a lot of people have television on in the background.
Yeah.
You know, or radio too. I mean, a lot of people have the radio going on, lyrics and songs and whatever. Yeah. And the question really is like, if you're doing a task that involves learning, then it's sounding like that inhibits it. When there are words and lyrics and or people talking.
Yeah.
They said they didn't really figure out if it's just soft, quiet music. Like you said, instrumental.
Yeah.
That whether that has an effect. I don't think they tested that. But I remember or recalled other things in the past where that improves your.
Yeah.
You know,
they say classical music helps with that type of stuff.
But we're adults also. Think about it
exactly,
as a kid.
Exactly.
And while the child may not think that it's distracting, it certainly could.
It could be.
To their brain.
Right.
But since we are experts in science, we're just podcasters.
Exactly.
So, but like, you know, the children with TV, you know, children really, you know, this was like the American something pediatrics said, like, you shouldn't even watch TV before 2 years old.
Oh, right.
I mean, it shouldn't even be on when a child is that young.
Yeah. Right.
You know?
Right.
There are some learning tools and some other things, but you know, now like a kid's 2 years old and he's swiping left to work his iPad and create a PowerPoint presentation.
You know? Right.
I mean, my son the other day is like, check out this presentation I made. I'm like, are you kidding me?
Your son created a PowerPoint?
Like, yeah. They're like doing stuff in school with video and words.
Wow.
And like, I mean, it's crazy.
That is
crazy. It is crazy. And it's like, it's just on an iPad.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like,
wow, that's great.
Don't get me started. It's really great and beneficial to their educational system. No, that was sarcasm. I smelled that. So here, I have some tips on what we can do to reduce the noise and increase the level of learning or just decrease the distraction, if you will.
Okay.
So first one, just as I was mentioning, is don't leave the TV, radio, or electronics on in the background. You know, like we said, if it's soft music without lyrics,
right,
you know, that may be okay. It could be soothing. It could be something. But when I recalled when I was younger, we wanted to sit in front of the TV. You know, this is like going completely the other end of the spectrum.
Sure, sure.
I remember saying, no, it doesn't distract. I mean, I remember that, like I was doing math or something like that where I can do it while the TV's on.
Yeah.
And the reality is I probably could do it,
but
how much better would I have been?
Yeah.
You know, would it have been
or faster?
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Cause then you're like, okay. And then you start.
Yeah. And I'm the same way now, even, I mean, I do certain activities and work where I can listen to certain non-instrumental music, but for the most part throughout my day, I can't.
Yeah.
You know, it is distracting for me.
Right.
I've tried listening to like interviews and stuff like that, or even like some TED Talks and that.
Yeah.
You know, to try to get some positive like stuff during the day.
Yeah.
So, And it just becomes difficult. I find myself then watching it or removing myself from my task and listening.
Yeah. I do the same thing where I turn on, I have my laptop next to my desk, so I'll use it to plug in my headphones and maybe, you know, watch or listen to something on YouTube, because a lot of times YouTube will either have a comedy thing or a music. But then I'm like, what's going on with them? Why are they sounding like that? And then I look at the video and I'm getting too distracted. So I have to shut it off.
We were able to police ourselves. So that's the first one. Just leave it off, you know, any sort of noise, electronic, TV, radio, whatever.
Right.
The other is from the distraction standpoint of really is make eye contact with the child.
Okay.
Which we've talked about communication and how important it is, and just speak really clearly.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's enunciation,
articulation.
They're able to see your lips, move and do that. That's the other part, actually, really. And so I kind of spoke too soon, but it's make sure that a toddler does see your face.
Okay.
So that's, which kind of goes along with the eye contact, anyways.
But, they kind of have to see.
But like, you know, even when you're communicating with them on a playground.
Uh-huh.
You know, and it's loud and there's a ton of distractions. If they don't see you, it's kind of really hard to know sometimes that you're the one talking and you're like, you know, hey, get over here. Or, you know, hey, we got to leave, you know, and it's distracting. There's other things going on and other noise.
Yeah.
The truth is they may not be able to process what you're saying.
Right.
There's too much stimulus. Yeah, there's too much going on.
Yeah.
So that is something, you know, whether it is and I'm sure teachers know that. This is more for, you know, yourself when you are in the situation of playground or even at home and there's noise. It's like, I mean, I think of the other day, I won't say which child, one of my children was watching a movie or watching a show.
Yeah.
And I said something. I recalled it was like, you know, hey, I need you to blah, 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 whatever. Didn't hear it. And this is very common. This happened to me when I was a kid. Said it twice. Didn't hear it. Finally had to stand in front of the television between his eyes and the television.
Yeah.
And he's like, what? Like, literally, it wasn't like he was ignoring me.
Yeah.
He literally did not hear me say anything.
Right. It just tunes right out.
It was just complete focus, unifocused on whatever ridiculous, you know.
Yeah. Well, I've seen that sounded in judgy. Adults. Not to judge you, right? Yeah, whatever ridiculous thing they're
watching. Whatever ridiculous show he was watching.
Naturally.
Yeah.
Better than the shows that I watch. No, I've seen that with adults. Like, you know, sometimes they're so into whatever it is that's going on and you want them to do something. Like, I've had to go do that where I got to stand in front of whatever they're doing or turn their head a little bit and be like, hey.
Yeah.
Like,
oh. Grab them by the face.
Yeah, exactly. Pull them out by their
Listen
neck.
Listen to me.
Yeah.
So that's something. You definitely, you know, they can pick out mouth movements and things like that. So you want to make sure that they can see your face. If a child doesn't understand what you're talking about or doesn't, you know, use simpler words or use fewer words, you know, and this is something that we've said about tips for communication with children is one or two words often is enough. You know, upstairs.
Right.
Not, hey, it's time for bed. You need to get upstairs because we're going to have a good night's sleep. Just upstairs.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's it.
Right.
You know, same thing. 5 minutes.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, like we're leaving.
Yeah.
You know, all kinds of stuff like that where the
walk.
Yeah, totally. They need less words and less instruction so they can process that. And then the last thing, if a child's having behavior problems at school, they're suggesting to make sure that they are able to hear in the classroom.
Mm, yeah, yeah.
So that could, you know, they're not paying attention. They're getting really easily distracted.
Yeah.
It could be a hearing issue.
Yeah.
You know, or I should say a concentration issue from the distraction of other people talking.
Right. Because they can't hear what's really going on. So they get distracted by what's going on around.
Because it certainly is not going to be our own child who's distracting him.
Of course not. It's everyone
somebody else's child who's going to distract ours.
There is a thing about visuals, too. And I know that's not exactly the same thing. But like, I know there was some studies or some people that I knew that had problems growing up and learning because they weren't aware that they didn't have good vision. So until they finally figured out they sure. needed glasses. They couldn't even see half what was going on the chalkboard.
And nobody brings it up.
And no one brings it up, and they're too scared to in some level, or they don't understand that they can't see it, and they think they need to be able to see it, and they don't think about it.
Well, there's all kinds of stuff about, you know, the learning process, whether it's visual, auditory, kinesthetic, you know, the different learning types and the different learning. In fact, it was really interesting. So we had grandparents' day at my children's school, and noticed again, and I had forgotten about this, but I showed the grandparents, the children had rocking chairs. Mm-hmm. A lot of them, not all children, but a lot of them have rocking chairs, so they actually can move while they're sitting. And I guess, I mean, it's a great idea, you know, and so they can actually, like, you know, have some movement and they're not going to get in trouble,
right?
You know, because that's something that a lot of kids need. That
should teach on a sit and spin. Put the lesson in front of them and just turn it around and look up, you know, sit and spin
Timmy
for the younger ones.
Turning and spinning around. Yeah, no, that's great. So basically, I mean, you know, the gist of this is just to really, you know, provide the best environment a child can for learning, you know, and part of that seems to be that noise is distracting, you know, overall, you know, and to think about that where, you know, we often will play music, we have the television in the background, you know, and we're telling our child like, hey, go study, you know, over there, or go do something that, you know, requires something. So I think that's something to consider and think about, that, you know, the next time you're saying to your child, like, hey, it's time to do homework, you know, it's maybe make a much more quiet, peaceful environment for them.
Right.
You know, to do that.
Yeah.
And so I think that, and then you'll all have genius kids.
Exactly.
I guarantee
it's the formula for success.
Put my stamp on it. Also, too, if you guys have any feedback.
Yeah.
Podcast at
Dudes to Dads
at dudes2dads.com. Facebook, Dudes to Dads.
Twitter,
Dudes to Dads.
Yeah.
We're all over the place.
We're all over the map. And please go to iTunes and leave 5-star reviews if you can.
Because give us
really
some likes. Give us some tweets. Give us some love.
We'd love to hear from you. And, you know, I think the feedback really helps move the show along in different directions. Because
it does. We've got some great show ideas.
Sure.
People have asked questions.
Yeah. I love that stuff. You know, and we'd love to hear different experiences from different people. So, you know, if you have feedback.
Even though we love to hear ourselves talk and love our own ideas. Yeah. I know. It doesn't even matter if anybody listens. Yeah, I just want
to
hear myself.
To be honest
talk.
With you, it almost doesn't matter. But we prefer that you do listen because, you know, we want to be not. Otherwise, we're just talking to ourselves.
Yeah, which I do a lot anyway. So here, there's like, you know, at least a couple people listening. So yeah, exactly. It makes sense.
It validates our existence.
Yeah, actually, the stats have been great. So appreciate everybody listening and the feedback.
Yeah.
It's been really good. So.
For sure.
With that, another day.
Yeah.
Usually you say another dollar, but that's not our catchphrase.
Yeah, and that's not happening today.
So on behalf of Alan and myself, this is Jason. In case you forgot how you've been listening to quite some time.
Exactly.
We will see you next time.
See you next week.